I'll tell you why Kenya is more famous than most other African countries. It's not the wildlife, the athletes, history, tourism, or all that stuff people claim. It is because you are now talking about Kenya and not those other, more famous, countries. It is the Kenyans who shape what is said about them. They write their own stories and the rest of the world reports what Kenyans said. Kenya has no natural resources. You see, all African countries, South Africa has the economy, Nigeria has the population, Egypt has the history, but Kenya only has its people. The Kenyan human resource is what makes Kenya noticeable in a pool of African nations with great economies, rich history, vast natural resources, oil, gas, diamond, copper, gold, etc. Kenya has none. Tech innovativeness. In a country of no resources, Kenyans are forced to take more aggressive and innovative ways to be competitive and provide jobs for its population. This is why her economy is highly diversified. From mobile money, technology cities, tourism, vibrant media and finance industry, Kenya's service industry is the most vibrant in Africa. In 2016, Kenya overtook South Africa as the country with most businesses investments in other African countries. Businesses amongst Kenyans are highly profitable. If your product is good, all Kenyans will buy it. Take a look at Mountain, South Africa, and Safaricom, Kenya, for example. Mountain was founded in 1994 and is present in 24 countries. Safaricom was founded in 1999 and only operates in Kenya. As of the 1st of September 2018, Mountain had a market capitalization of $10.5 billion while Safaricom had a market capitalization of $11.5 billion. Mountain shares on the same day sold at $5.50 while Safaricom shares sold at 28 cents, which tells you that Safaricom is highly undervalued. Internet penetration and literacy. Kenyan online community is not the largest in Africa. Nigeria has more people using the internet than the entire Kenyan population. 30 million out of 50 million Kenyans have smartphones. You dare not pick a fight with Kenyans online. Kenyans will take on South Africa and up next jump to Nigerians online in disagreements mainly because of how a Kenyan was treated by Nigeria immigration at the Lagos airport or a South African politician said something bad about a Kenyan singer. In 2014, CNN was forced to issue an editorial apology and send its chairman to meet with Kenyan Foreign Affairs Minister over some hashtag hotbed of terror remark a CNN reporter made about Kenya. This goes back to the idea of how Kenyans want to be seen or represented. They hate bad press. Real estate is a section that cannot go unnoticed. Kenya has experienced a real estate boom in the past two decades. As South Africa, Nigeria and Egypt continue to struggle with economic depression and inflation, Kenya economy registered 5.7% growth. With an already oversupply of malls in Kenya, the skyline of cities in Kenya is changing with tallest building in Africa already under construction in Nairobi. Actually, if you look at the buildings under contraction in Africa, it almost looks like by year 2021 the top 10 tallest towers will be dominated by Kenyan towers. This goes back to the people. It's not the great resources, not the history, just the people. It's very misleading to assume Kenya was never famous. The Queen of England herself received news of her father's death whilst in Kenya. The fame Kenya can associate with can be attributed to many reasons among them. Politically, Kenya enjoys a comfortable position in global politics, allied to most of the developed nations, which has in turn yielded to increase in popularity. This can be due to Jomo Kenyatta's foreign diplomatic policies carried out post-independence, culminating to the construction of UNEP headquarters in Nairobi, Kenya. Geographically, Kenya is located at an ideal position which can be seen in the vast natural ecosystem, just like all other African countries, only this time the equator splits Kenya into two distinctive halves. The Mara ecosystem, Lake Nakuru ecosystem and of course Mount Kenya ecosystem are some of the famous examples of this. This climate also is conducive for farming, making Kenya a leading tea and horticulture exporter. The beaches along Kenya's coast are some of the best in the world, and the proximity of the port of Mombasa to major international seaways makes it an ideal destination for revelers. The people of Kenya are truly a unique people. They have shown resilience over the years, even when most of the African nations were plunging into civil war, coups. The innovative nature of the Kenyans have given them recognition, M-Pesa for instance, a technological tool for money transfer that's more accessible and efficient than banks, cheaper and safer too. Providing money lending platform right at the palm of anyone who can buy a phone, using the subscriber phone number as the bank account. Genius. Twitter, Kenyans enjoy one of the fastest internet connections in the world. Yes, the internet in Kenya is faster than USA and most of the world with a ranking of 14 globally. This fast internet does not go to waste. Kenyans on Twitter caught as they are referred to as lethal as any land force. They are an impulsive and angry lot who will tear each other down but are violently united to fend off anybody saying anything negative about their country which they hate so much yet fight so dearly to protect. The Silicon Savannah, as Kenya is referred to as a result of the government policy on technology, consistently pumping billions into the sector and always adopting new forms of technology to make life easier for their people. Kenya's foreign policy. This is the age-old policy culminating from independence and consistently applied till date. With a policy that ensures it maintains a high bargaining power in most global and regional debates. It has hosted most of the international conventions, bringing most world leaders to its soil more than any other African country, and this is in the past 2 years alone. Including the Holy See. This has given it a status quo in the African continent as a major ally with solid relationships with Washington through to London all the way to Mumbai into Moscow and closer home to Kampala, Joburg, Lusaka and of course the world's biggest economy, China. This can be the biggest brother who spoils you silly. Kenya would need cheap loans, good roads, name it, the Chinese have it, and with a global command like China's, Kenya can ride the tide too.